After Gordon had been washed and polished, he rushed away to meet the visitors. But a signal diverted Gordon into a siding. He was very upset. "I'm going to be late," he muttered. A huge engine rocketed by.
"Steaming pistons, who's that?"
Gordon soon found out. When he arrived at the shed, the huge engine was humming quietly.
"Who are you?"
"This is Spencer. He's the fastest engine in the world."
But secretly, Gordon was impressed.
"I'm the Duke and Duchess's private engine. I take them everywhere."
"There will be a party for the Duke and Duchess at Marin Station."
"That's far away over Gordon's Hill."
"You'll need to take on plenty of water," muttered Gordon.
"I have plenty of water," wheezed Spencer, and he raced away.
"I was only trying to be useful," grunted Gordon.
Spencer showed the Duke and Duchess many beautiful places. But he never once stopped to take on more water. Gordon and Thomas were collecting passengers when Spencer raced through on his way to the party.
"Don't forget the water!"
"Who cares?"
"He'll be in trouble soon," sighed Thomas. And Spencer was. He ran out of water on Gordon's Hill.
"Why didn't I listen?"
Gordon was looking forward to seeing Spencer.
"Run out of water?" he teased.
"Yes," snapped Spencer. "I must have a leaky tank."
"Perhaps," smiled Gordon. "But we better hurry. Everyone is waiting."
Gordon switched to Spencer's line and was coupled up. Then they set off.
"See?"
said Gordon.
"We're right on time."
But Spencer was embarrassed.
"So what do you think of Spencer now, Thomas?"
"Too much puff and not enough steam."
"Well done, Gordon," said Sir Topham Hatt. "You are the fastest engine on Sodor."
"I know that,"
muttered Gordon.